Okay, good evening, my dear students. Welcome to GitHub, India's e-learning platform. Good evening, Vivek Reddy. So I suppose, am I audible? Please quickly respond. Am I audible and my voice is clear? Because I'm using some different network today. So I hope so that can... Good evening, guys. So this is Suraj Gopi. Well, I welcome you all to the live class on the theory of machine part 2 of the damp vibration. Good evening, Shri Kumar. Okay, so I'm quickly having a brief idea of how to wash your hands so that you can protect yourself against the infections. So there are 12 steps so that you can be safe at your home. So these are the 12 steps how to wash your hands, which is very important, and to fight against the COVID-19 virus. Okay, clear. So please tell me, guys, if issue is there, because from afternoon I'm facing some difficulty with the network. So I request everyone to please respond to my okay, fine. So these are the 12 steps which you can wash your hands. Is very important, very information very important information I would like to share you. So please try to follow this 12 steps, wash your hands. Okay, fine. So let me talk about the very important thing, that is how to reach out if you're facing any difficulty or if you're having any guidance support required. You definitely reach out at this number, that is +911 2397 8046. Chinese virus kahiye sir. Ha, Chinese virus bhi bol sakte hain. Like many of the, like Trump is also saying about the Chinese virus, so it's like a synonym for the coronavirus. Okay, correct, Jitesh, absolutely correct. Clear, theek hai, fine. So it's very important, because now you might have seen in the news daily, like you might be seeing in the news channels, it's a very deadly virus. So please don't take this as lightly. Don't go outside your home. It's very important to just stay outside, stay inside your home, and don't go outside. Okay, fine. Ghar rahiye, swasth rahiye. That is the only thing which I want to share with you. Be at your home. Don't go outside if you want to stay alive. That's the thing which I would like to share you. Okay, very good evening, Pawan, Jitan. let's introduce about me. My name is Suraj Gopi. I have 5+ year experience. I'm tech in thermal science and engineering. I have mentored more than 5,000 students for GATE, ESC, and SSC. My area of expertise is, as you can see, mechanics, thermal, applied heat transfer, industrial, and theory of machines. So this is the area where I usually take. And please quickly respond to me, because yesterday we were having some issue at the same time. So I have switched the network for you guys. Okay, so yesterday we have studied about the equation of damped system. Okay, we have discussed about the equation of damped system, very very important, and we found out the relation of x double dot plus c by m x dot plus k by m x is equal to 0. Okay, so this we have discussed in the yesterday session. Also we have found out that 2 zeta omega n, what is zeta? Zeta is the coefficient of damping. Clear? So 2 zeta omega n is equal to c by m. So if I substitute the value of c by m in main equation, then I'll be getting the expression as x double dot plus 2 zeta omega n plus omega n whole square into x. Okay, so this is the equation of damped system, very, very important. So this is the equation of damped system. Okay, now we'll be having a solution for the same. Vivek, okay, fine. So have you understood? Yesterday we have a discussion on this, the damped system. So damped system are having a general equation of x double dot plus 2 zeta omega n x dot plus omega n whole square x equal to 0. Is that clear? Fine. Any difficulty in this, for understanding this? Yes, very good. So we have discussed yesterday the critically damped, also the under damped and over damped. So we'll be defining again. So if zeta is greater than 1, then it's a case of your over damped condition. If zeta is equal to 1, then there's a case of your critically damped condition. And zeta is less than 1, then we are talking of under damped condition. That is a viscous damping. Over damping is also known as Coulomb's damping. Clear? Fine. So yes, is that clear? So if I talk about again about this expression, so if I calculate the general solution, that will be x is equal to a e to the power alpha 1 t plus b e to the power alpha 2 t. This is the solution of this above equation. This is basically the solution of this equation. Okay, if alpha 1 is not equal to alpha 2, fine. Or it can be one more problem solution, that is a plus bt e to the power alpha t if your alpha 1 is equal to alpha 2. Okay, so the equation can have probable two solution, that is x is equal to a e to the power alpha 1 t plus b e to the power alpha 2 t if alpha 1 is not equal to alpha 2, and if you are having x is equal to a plus bt e to the power alpha t if alpha 1 is not if alpha 1 is equal to alpha 2 is equal to alpha. Is that clear? Fine. I know, because in my session, in my locality, it's having uploading issue. So upload speed is not that much, because everyone is working from home from the area where I'm staying. So that's the reason, like, it is having a huge load on the server. Okay. Fine. So this is the probable solution. Now, so if I calculate, let me hide this so that you will be able to understand clearly. So if I calculate alpha 1, okay, that means alpha 1 comma 2 is equal to minus zeta plus minus under root square zeta square minus 1 into omega n. Okay, into omega n. So this is the like the value of alpha 1 and alpha 2. It's very, very important. So alpha 1 and alpha 2 is equal to minus zeta plus minus under root zeta square minus 1. So you can have probable three basic equation. You can have probable three basic equation, that is your alpha 1 comma 2 equal to minus zeta plus minus zeta square minus 1 under root omega. Okay, so if zeta is greater than 1, then we are talking about over condition. If zeta is equal to 1, we are talking about critically damped condition. If zeta is less than 1, then we are basically talking about the under damped condition. Clear? Abhishek, Vikas, Shri Kumar, Pavan, Vivek. Is that clear? Now let us discuss one by one about the overdamped condition. Now what is overdamped condition? Overdamped condition is basically when your zeta is greater than 1. If zeta is greater than 1, then it's a condition of overdamped condition. The probable solution for this will be x will be equal to a e to the power alpha 1 t plus b e to the power alpha t 2, and alpha 1 and alpha 2 values I have just placed. It is minus zeta plus zeta square minus 1 omega n t, and this will be minus, okay? So minus zeta minus under root zeta square minus 1 omega n t. Clear? So after getting this solution, we found out that audio and video are not synced at all. Okay, please respond to me if you're having still an issue. I'm waiting for you guys. Now it's okay. So we found out the solution of x is equal to a e to the power minus zeta plus the root zeta square minus 1 omega n t plus b e to the power. So in this case, when you plot the graph, between x and t, we found out that it is not having any vibration. Let us check the graph between x and t. X and t. Okay, so when you plot a graph, you found out that the graph is clear. So in this case, there is no vibration. When you see at the graph, when you plotted this graph, I found out there is no vibration. Why there is no vibration? Because there is no frequency. There is no vibration. Is that clear? You can see at the graph, there is no simple harmonic motion. There is no oscillation of the, it is continuously decreasing. Yes, roots are real. The roots are real, definitely will be having an exponential decrement. So if this is the case, so in that case, we'll be having no vibration. And if there's no vibration, there is no harmonic motion, there is no periodic motion. Okay, so is that clear? There is no vibration. There is no harmonic motion. If this is the case, then definitely we are not having the vibration scenario. Is that clear? Roots are real. Yes, definitely roots are real because your alpha is greater than 1. If FL is greater than 1, then we will be having the real roots. Okay, fine. So no vibration, no harmonic motion, no periodic motion. So this is a system when we are having significance of wave is A and B are basically constant. I'll be telling you when this is basically used in the magnitude of your amplitude. Okay, as there is no vibration, A and B are basically the constant. A and B are basically constants. Clear? A and B are constant. Clear? Now, let us talk about the second case. Second case is critically damped condition. Okay, so critically damped condition means when zeta is equal to 1. If zeta is equal to 1, so we can definitely found out that alpha 1 is equal to alpha 2 is equal to minus omega n. So alpha 1 is equal to alpha 2 is equal to minus omega n. Because what is alpha 1? Just now I have said you, what is alpha 1? Alpha 1 is, yes, alpha 1 and alpha 2, these are the values. If zeta is equal to 1, then you are definitely will be having only minus omega n as the value of alpha 1 is equal to alpha 2. Okay, so if this is the case, then this is the solution. Now again, this they are having a real roots. If they are real roots, so definitely there is no vibration. There is no vibration. Okay, if this there is no vibration, let us plot the graph between x and t. So this is your x, this is your t. Let us plot a graph between x and t. Fine. So we'll be having a graph something like this. So this is the graph when you are having zeta is equal to 1. There is no vibration, there is no amplitude, no amplitude, there is no amplitude, there is no vibration. So that means we are again talking about a no vibration condition. So now what we can conclude that if you are having an overdamped condition, that is zeta greater than 1, and also if you are having a critically damped condition, that is zeta equal to 1, in both the scenarios we will be having no vibration. Very, very important case, very, very important. Okay, understood? No vibration. So if I, and one more thing I'll have to tell you, in this case, your response is very fast. Your response is very, yes, response is very fast in case of critically damped. So can you tell me where we are actually using this critically damped? Response is very quick or fast. Yes, quickly tell me where we are basically using the critically damped system. In overdamped, there is no vibration. In the case, there is no vibration, but in overdamped, the response time is very low. In critically damped, the response time is very low. You can see the graph. Quickly, it is being converged towards the y-axis. Okay, like this. It is basically now. If I plot a graph on a single graph, if I plot for overdamped and critically damped, if a plot for x, this is for your critically damped, and this is for so this value is basically when zeta is equal to 1, this is 1, zeta is greater than 1. Is that clear? So an overdamped, let me take with an example. The best example of the overdamped is, yes, quickly tell me what will be the best example of overdamped condition. Anyone who can tell me where we are using overdamped, example of overdamped. Overdamped. That. Okay, try to refresh this. I suppose now it's okay. Fine. So now it's okay. So omega t, this is basically the vibration. Your vibration. This is frequency of vibration, or we can say the angular velocity of vibration. Clear? Fine. So let us suppose omega t is equal to under root 1 minus zeta square into omega n. So I have placed this omega d over here in this equation. Now I've tried to find out the solution by using x is equal to a e to power omega 1 alpha 1 into t plus b e to power alpha 2 into t. I found out the yes, I'm explaining once again, Srikumar. Don't worry, I will be starting from again. Fine. So under damped condition is basically your zeta is less than 1. Zeta is less than 1. Okay. So alpha 1 2 will be equal to, is basically zeta plus minus under root zeta square minus 1 into omega n. Okay. So in this case, if zeta is less than 1, that means we are talking about the imaginary roots. Imaginary roots. Okay. So that is why, I'm using an iota sign over here, I sign, very very important. So, and also I have assumed this value, that is under root 1 minus zeta square into omega n, a new parameter known as omega d. Okay, and what is omega d? Omega d is basically your damped vibration. It's basically your damped vibration. We'll be understanding once again this damped vibration. Is the frequency of damped vibration. Is that correct? So the solution for the above equation is x is equal to a e to the power alpha 1 into t and b e to the power alpha 2 into t. The solution for the above equation is e to the power minus zeta omega n t c1. Let us suppose the c1 I am assuming to be a sin phi and c2 I assume to be a cos phi. What is a sin phi? What is sin theta cos theta plus cos theta sin theta? Yes, so we'll be having omega n t plus phi. So when you solve this equation, you'll be getting x is equal to, is basically, if I have this expression written over here, so this is a sin phi into cos omega d t plus a cos phi into sin omega d t. So this is basically, if you take a common outside, this is a sin theta b into cos beta plus cos theta into sin beta. It's basically a sin theta plus beta. Clear? So I have used this expression and I found a final expression, that is x is equal to e to the power minus zeta omega n t into a sin omega d t into phi. Now what is a? This value a e to the power minus omega n is basically the amplitude. We are talking about the amplitude. Okay. This is the damped frequency or damped vibration. This is where we talk about damped vibration. Now you can see it's a sine wave. If it is a sine wave, definitely we'll be having a sine wave. So definitely we'll be having a vibration. We'll be having a vibration case. Is that clear? Is that clear? Understood? And also you can see, can anyone tell me with time, what is the effect on amplitude? What is amplitude? Amplitude is AE minus zeta omega NT. Now, with time, what is happening with the amplitude? Whether it is decreasing or increasing? Quickly tell me, what is the amplitude value with the time? If I increase time, what is happening with amplitude? Whether it's decreasing? Exactly. Very good, Sri Kumar. You can see it is e to the power minus t. So if you increase the value of t, your amplitude will definitely dies out or definitely will be decreasing. So I can write this as amplitude decreases. Amplitude decreases. With increase in time. Is that clear? So you can directly see from the relation, with the increase in time, your amplitude is definitely going to decrease. Clear? So because it is due to the negative sign, which is written over here, e to the power minus. So due to this negative sign, we have a decrease in the amplitude. So now let us understand what is the frequency of vibration. So your omega d, what is omega d? Omega d is your damped vibration. Okay, so omega d is equal to 1 minus zeta square under root into omega n. Very, very important. Can anyone tell me what will be the omega d? Will it be changing for a particular system? No, it won't be changing because omega n and zeta both are constant for a particular system. So it is constant. It is constant for a particular system. For a particular system, it's exactly constant. It doesn't vary with the parameters. Okay, because omega n depends upon k and mass, and zeta basically depends upon mass and your coefficient of damping. So it basically is constant for a system. So omega d, that is a damped vibration, is also constant for a particular system. So if I plot a graph, now you have seen amplitude is constantly decreasing with the increase in time. So if you plot a graph for this, so you will be having a graph which is dying out. Okay, so this is a graph where your amplitude is basically, you can see your amplitude is decreasing constantly. Constantly, is that clear? Sir, in phi phase difference, sir, is phi phase difference? Yes, phi is phase difference. Yes, I forgot to tell you about that. Phi is the phase difference. Phi is phase difference. Okay, is that clear? Now you can see the graph. Your amplitude is constantly decreasing. This is the amplitude. This x1, x2. X3, they're the amplitude which is constantly decreasing. Okay, and let us talk about the omega d again. Omega d is the frequency or the vibration, damped vibration. This is equal to under root 1 minus zeta square into omega n. If I want to calculate the time period, what is time period of this damped? The time period will be 2 pi by omega d. Okay. And also, what will be the frequency of damping? The frequency of damping will be equal to omega d by 2 pi. This is for one cycle. This is for one cycle. Is that clear? So now you can see from this point to this point, this is your time period td. Okay, again, from this point to this point, again, td. Again, from this point to this point is again TD. Is that clear? So let us first of all tell me, at time t equal to 0, can you tell me what is the magnitude, what is the amplitude you are having? Quickly tell me, at time t equal to 0, what is the amplitude of vibration? At time t equal to 0, what is the amplitude? Your amplitude is basically x naught. You can see from this diagram, your amplitude is equal to x naught. Okay, fine. Again, if I calculate at time t is equal to td, what is the amplitude? Let us suppose this is x1. Okay, so it is x1 is equal to x e to the power x e to the power, or let me write a, because I've used a over here, so let me write a. So basically a into e to the power minus zeta omega n t d into sine phi. Same thing, just you can see this expression which we have got it. This is the final expression. If you put t equal to t d, if you put t equal to t d, fine, you will be getting this expression. You will be putting t equal to t d. So a sine what is omega d into t d? That will be 2 pi, and sine 2 pi plus phi is again phi. So we'll be getting the value of x is equal to, or x1 is equal to a e to the power minus zeta omega n t d into sine phi. Okay, let us take another value, because that will clear your concept. If you take at t equal to 2 t d, that is point this one, point B. This is point B. Let us take this as point A. So this is point A. This is point B. So at t equal to td, at t equal to 2 dd, your x2 is equal to a e to the power minus zeta omega n 2d into sine 5 again. What is sine 4 pi into plus 5? Sine 4 pi plus 5 is sine 5 again. The first quadrant. Okay. So if you take the ratio of x naught by x, let us understand this ratio of x naught by x1. So it will be equal to e to the power, it will be equal to e to the power zeta omega n td. Okay. X naught will be equal to, x naught will be equal to x or a sine phi. So when you take this ratio, you will be getting zeta omega n t d. Again, let us take another value, that is x1 by x2. Let us take the ratio of x1 by x2. If you take the ratio of x1 by x2, it will again will be coming it to be e to the power zeta omega n t d. So what we have found from this, we have found that the ratio of x0 by x1 is equal to x1 by x2 is equal to x2 by x3, so on, is equal to constant, is equal to constant, and this is equal to e to the power zeta omega n t d. Is that clear? It's very, very important, this concept. Clear? So let me write again. So this is the case which we have discussed. At t equal to 0, your x naught is equal to a sine phi. At t equal to td, your x1 is equal to a e to the power zeta omega n td. Fine. So when we found out the ratio, we found out that x0 by x1 is equal to x2, x1 by x2, it is equal to e to the power zeta omega n td. Fine. Let us suppose I am using a new term. It is e equal to power delta. Fine. And this delta is basically known as, or e to the power delta is known as the decrement ratio. This is known as the decrement ratio. Okay. This is known as the decrement ratio. Is that clear? What is decrement ratio? It is equual to e to the power zeta omega n td, or e to the power delta. Clear? Is that clear? Fine. Now, there is a new term which you need to understand, that is a logarithmic value. Okay, that is a logarithmic decrement. What is logarithmic decrement? It is basically known as delta is equal to ln the decrement. Dr is the decrement ratio. Dr is basically the decrement ratio. Dr is basically the decrement ratio. So, if I take the value of decrement, that is e to the power zeta omega n e to the power zeta into omega n td. So we are getting the value of delta is equal to what is delta? Delta is logarithmic decrement. So delta is equal to zeta omega n into td. Okay. So when I substitute this value, you will be getting, you can place the value of td as 2 pi by omega n d. So this is equal to zeta into omega n. Instead of td, I can write 2 pi by omega d, and omega d I can substitute the value as omega n into 1 minus zeta square under root is equal to omega d. You can place this, substitute this value, and ultimately we'll be getting our expression as logarithmic decrement delta is equal to 2 pi zeta upon 1 minus zeta square under root. Is that clear? This is very, very important expression. So now you have found out that the logarithmic decrement is equal to, it's a function of the damping coefficient. Okay. Is that clear? Or we can say damping ratio. Fine. Please tell me if you're having any difficulty to understand. Yes, anyone? So you found out that the logarithmic decrement, that is your LD, logarithmic decrement, is basically the function of zeta. Clear? And also we found out that x0 by x1 is equal to x1 by x2. I have done some numerical, guys, so that you can have a clear idea on this topic. Yeah, fine. So this is about the logarithmic decrement. Let us have a quick discussion on this. Then we'll be starting the numerical portion. Okay. So critical damping coefficient. What is critical damping coefficient? That means the value of C when zeta is equal to 1, the corresponding value of C is equal to CC. Okay. Is that clear? So you already know 2 zeta omega n is equal to C by m. Fine. If zeta is equal to 1, your C is equal to CC. So let again write, this is 2 into 1 into omega n is equal to CC by n. Take this two equation, this is equation 1, this is equation 2. Take the ratio of equation 1 by equation 2. So we'll be getting this as 2 zeta into omega n upon 2 into omega n is equal to C by CC, or we can say your zeta is equal to C by CC. Now we can have a new definition of damping. That is, your damping ratio is the ratio of the damping coefficient to the critical, actual damping coefficient to the critical damping coefficient. Okay, so I can write the new definition of zeta. What is zeta? I can write zeta is equal to actual damping coefficient divided by critical damping coefficient. Sometimes we are also using this expression in for finding out some of the numericals. Okay, clear? Fine. Now let me have a one important discussion for with you guys. Let us suppose I'm having a value of x1. Let us try this problem. Quickly. You need to solve this problem quickly, and I'll be telling you about the concept also, how to solve this problem whenever you're having a question like this. Let us suppose logarithmic decrement, the value of logarithmic decrement is given as 0.2. You have to calculate the value of x1 by x5. Yes, tell me how to calculate. Just now I have told you about this concept. Okay. But in that case, your x1 by x2 was there. Mm-hmm. Now it's okay, my dear friend. So where we can see the damping and types of damping in real world, if I know they are used in dampers, otherwise where they use in autonomous brakes. Yes, like wherever we need to have no vibration, in that case we'll be using the o-damped, like in the door closer. You might have seen, if you push the door, there is no vibration. This basically the door will be closing slowly, so there is no vibration whenever we don't have vibration. If we want to have a no vibration but quick response, in that case we'll be using the critical damping condition, that is zeta is equal to 1. If I talk about the underdamped condition, basically we don't need to, we are not basically preferring the underdamped. Why? Because we're having a vibration. If you're having a vibration in the system, that will definitely decrease the life of the system. Okay, Sriraj? Is that clear? Fine. So let us quickly solve this problem. If zeta is equal to 0.2, calculate the value of x1 by x2. That means the ratio of the amplitude of the first wave to the fifth wave. How to solve this problem? Anyone who has tried or who knows the concept, I'll be solving you for guys. In this case, how to solve this problem is, you know x1 by, you basically know the ratio of this one. x1 by x2 is equal to x2 by x3 is equal to x3 by x4 is equal to constant. Like so on. It's basically tending to infinity. It can go till any value. Now, if I want to write x1 by x1 by x5, and this is basically equal to e to the power delta, you know that. So I can write x1 by x5 as x1 by x2 into x2 by x3 into x3 by x4 into x4 by x5. We can write this like this. So you know individually the value is e to the power delta. Individually the value is e to the power delta. Is that clear? So what will be the final value? We are now, I've given you the hint. So it is basically 4 times e to the power delta. That means e to the power 4 delta. So by using this expression, you can get the value of the ratio of the amplitude of the first and the fifth wave. Is that clear? A fifth amplitude. Understood? So this is a very important concept. They are basically asking in every examination. And I suppose you'll be getting approximately... No, you won't be getting 1.05. You will be getting approximately 0.226, I suppose. Please check the answer. Are you getting the same answer? Yes, exactly. Sri Kumar, correct. So, e to the power 4 delta, you will be getting approximately 2.226 as the value of the ratio of x1 by x5. Clear? Understood? Now let us solve a very important problem. I have made this problem by myself so that you can understand everything. I've designed this problem for you guys so that you can understand it, and you have to calculate omega d, delta, zeta and omega n. Please try to solve this problem, very important. So I've taken this problem myself. I've taken a random values. You might be getting some absurd value. So don't worry, but the main thing is how to approach for solving this type of problem is important. Okay, so mass is given 10 kg. Time period of the damping is given as 0.58 second. Your x1 by x7 is equal to 2. Calculate the value of damped vibration, your logarithmic decrement, your damping ratio, and the natural frequency of vibration. Very good, Chaitan Chinna. Very good, your answer is correct. Now try to solve this problem. Yes, mass is given, time period is given, x1 by x7 is given. Quickly try to solve it and tell me what will be the correct answer. I'm giving you some time. First of all, try to solve the first part. I'm also solving with you the first part, the A part, that is your vibration, damped vibration, omega d. How to calculate omega d? If time period is given, how to calculate omega d? Quickly. So omega d is equal to get this as 2 pi by Td. You can directly write what is that relation between the time period and the vibration, the damped vibration, that is equal to 2 pi by Td. So when you solve it, you'll be getting approximately, please tell me what is the value you're getting. Anyone who has solved, Sri Raj, Sri Kumar, Chetram, Anurag Singh, Farid Tul, please quickly, Abhishek, Ramesh Mohan. You will be getting as 10.83 radian per second. You'll be getting 10.83 radian per second. Is that clear? 10.83. Yes, exactly. Deepak and Sri Kumar, correct. Now let us try to solve the second part, the B portion. The B part, because that cover the entire damping, the your entire damping concept in the single problem. You have to calculate delta. How to calculate delta? Yes. Now in this, you are having some ratio of the amplitude given. So x1 by x7 is given. If x1 by x7 is given, x1 by x7 is given as to be 2. So you have to calculate delta. How to calculate? Same approach. So it will be x1 by x2 into x2 by x3 into x3 by x4. Same pattern. 0.115. Deepak, exactly correct. Very good. So you have to go with Deepak, solve for the third part. I'll be explaining the second part for the rest of the students. So x1 by x2 into x2 by x3 into x3 by x4 into x4 by x5 into x5 by x6 into x6 by x7 is equal to 2, and each value will be equal to e to the power delta. Each value will be equal to e to the power delta. So we're having 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So e to the power 6 delta is equal to 2. You'll be getting delta is equal to 0.115. Exactly. Very good, Sri Kumar. You have to take anti-log, or you can take ln 2 by 6. You're getting 0.115. So it is 0.115. Is that clear? So those are getting answers. Is absolutely correct. Anurag, correct. Now let us try to solve the third portion. How to calculate the value of zeta? Anyone who can tell me how to calculate the value of zeta? Which equation you will be using? For you have calculated part A. You have calculated part B. Now what about part C? How to calculate the third value, the zeta value? Which expression will be using? Zeta is equal to 0.0183. Exactly. Very good, Sri Raj. Absolutely correct. You'll be using a very basic equation. Let me remove this. You'll be getting delta is equal to 2 pi zeta upon 1 minus zeta square under root. Okay. This expression just now we have studied. I can show you right now. So this expression we have studied. The same expression I've told you, this is very, very important. So please make sure you are remembering this expression. So I've taken up the derivation of also so that you can understand. Okay. Now, so delta is equal to 2 pi zeta upon 1 minus zeta square. You'll be getting approximately the zeta value equal to 0.018. No, Deepak, won't be getting 1. You'll be getting 0.0183, precisely the correct answer. 0.0183. Okay, so you have calculated the first part, second part, and third part. How to calculate the fourth part? Which expression which you'll be using? Quickly tell me. For the calculation of the fourth part, that is the natural frequency, how to calculate omega n? Which expression we'll be using? There is a relation between omega 1 and omega d. Yes, there is a relation, that is your omega d is equal to. Yes, your omega d is equal to 1 minus zeta square under root into omega n. And you will be finding out the omega n is coming out to be. Your omega n is approximately coming out to be 10.832 radian per second. Is that clear? this value, the value of this 1 minus zeta square, you will be getting approximately 0.999 something. So you can take it as approximately 1. If it is approximately 1, in that case, omega t and omega n are exactly similar. Okay, fine. Understood? Yes, very good. Anurag, correct? Fine, so this completes your complete damped vibration. We have taken up every single thing which is there in the damped vibration and have taken some problems. And in MCQs, they are basically asking the questions from the logarithmic decrement. The question like this, the first question which we have discussed, they are basically asking a question like this. So please make sure you are solving some problem related to a similar concept. So last question I have taken for guys so that you can have how to use this expression. We are having many expression in the damped vibration. How to use this many expression? So it's very important. Is that clear? And you need to go with the same step-by-step method for solving these type of problem. Okay, fine. Is that clear? So this is it from my side. Sir, pura syllabus karvaoge? Yaar, no. I'm just completing only 60 to 70%. Jo topic uthata hu, that will be completing the next. So next time, please explain what is meant by static deflection in forced vibration. Yes, definitely. I have not started the forced vibration, and I'm also there might be chances I'll be changing the timing of the session because in the night time. The server is not at all supporting me, so there may be chances I'll be changing the time of the session also. It won't be 9 o'clock. Okay, so I would be talking with my team so that I can change my timing. Suggest a book for Tom. You can go for SS Ratan. There will be there be class one. Yes, definitely class will be there, don't worry. And it will be notified. Okay, there will be class tomorrow. SS Ratan is the best book. Don't go anywhere. SS Ratan is the best book for theory of machine. In this topic, weightage marks, sir, in this topic, weightage of the marks, like in the gate examination, you can expect between 8 to 12, maximum 12, between 8 to 12 marks, maximum 12, 8 marks you can expect from theory of machine. From top, okay. सर इम्पॉर्टेंट टॉपिक्स कंप्लीट करवाना. यस हाँ, इम्पॉर्टेंट टॉपिक्स मैं करवा देता हूँ. ठीक है, जो भी टॉपिक्स आई एम टेकिंग, आई एम बेसिकली कवरिंग द एंटायर टॉपिक. डोंट वरी अबाउट दैट. एंड सॉरी फॉर दैट टेक्निकल ग्लिच विच वी आर हैविंग, टेक्निकल इश्यूज विच वी आर हैविंग. लेट मी वर्क ऑन दिस बिकॉज कॉन्स्टेंटली फॉर द पास्ट 2 days इट्स हैपनिंग विद मी. सो लेट मी चेक विद माई सर्वर. ओके, सो थैंक यू गाइज. दिस इज इट फ्रॉम माई साइड. दिस इज सूरज गोपी साइनिंग ऑफ. And the vision course which I would like to tell you about, this is a vision batch 2 going on. After the successful launch of the batch 1, we are basically having a batch 2. So the main key thing is we are having a live evening classes for entire 1 year, 1.5 precisely, for GATE and ESE, for GATE and ESE complete syllabus. Okay, so in this, every day we'll be having subject related test. We'll be having your GATE level questions will be given by the team. ESE level question will be given by the team, 5 each for every class. Sir, any example of underdamping? Underdamping example, they are basically used where we need to have the vibration. Okay, is that clear? Yes. Fine. Like underdamped basically is used where we need to have quick response as well as some vibration is also required. Or we can say where underdamped is not required. Because there is some disadvantage of having zeta is equal to 1. If zeta is equal to 1, when we'll be talking about the resonance case. Okay, tomorrow we'll be talking about the resonance case. In that, we'll be discussing, it's very dangerous to have zeta equal to 1 because at one point of time, you are having your resonance or the frequency to be infinite. Okay, so we'll be discussing that tomorrow, why we are not preferring critically damped over the two of the cases. Are you covering all the topics? No, this is the last topic because previously I have covered more than like 50% of the theory of machine. Clear? Chinna, Narasimha, I will be basically covering 70%, 60 to 70%. But the topic which I am taking, that will be completed. And for gate point of view, the topics which are important, I definitely will be covering. Okay? Is that clear? Like gate trains we have completed, which is important for a gate vibration. We have completed more than 70%. Tomorrow we'll be having two sessions we'll be having for forced vibration. In that we'll be discussing about the magnification factor, very, very important, and the graphs also. So tomorrow's session I'll be writing very less. I'll be explaining more in the graphical manner. Okay. And if I talk about the discount which we are having, the scholarship which we are having on the MRP for the gate qualified student for the 17, 18, 19 and 20 for IIT and IIT and BTEC students, they can be for the 50% discount on RP, and ESC prelims qualified also can avail 50% off. If you're having any difficulty, you can definitely contact this number or you can mail to this two IDs. FM Karvauna, Anurag, let me check after this. I suppose FM is already been covered. Narurag, FM January month mein cover ho gaya tha. It was covered in the month of January. You can see the playlist. It is already being covered. So we can definitely look out the lectures by Vikas Bhadauria. You can clarify your concept. Okay. Sir, I qualified GATE 2020. Then you are eligible for 50% off on MRP. Anurag. Fine. Just only if you are having a qualified marks in any of the GATE like 17, 18, 19, 20, you are eligible for 50% flat off. So don't wait for the last moment. So if you are interested, definitely you need to reach out to this number. They'll be helping you out. You can mail to two IDs. Okay. So thank you guys. This is it from my side. This is Suraj Gopi signing off. You can prep smart, stay safe. I request everyone to please stay safe. Don't go outside of your home. It's very, very important. The virus is very deadly. Don't take it lightly. Please stay at your home, stay safe, be hygienic, clean, wash your hands properly. Sir, what time batch 1 class starts, sir? Batch 1 class is from 7 to 9 and 9:30 to 11:30. This is the timings of the batches. Yeah? Chinna Narasimha? How to avail? Our team will be contacting you, Anurag. Or just one thing, you can contact to this number, this 965005294. You can refer my name. He will be definitely helping you out. Okay. If you wish, you they will be reverting me. You can talk directly by calling this number. Fine. So don't worry. This is the sales team number. Or you can contact to this person, Mr. Anand Pandey. He will be helping you out. Just refer my name. He will understand. Like, don't worry. Chalo fir, let us wind up the session and please try to solve some problem. Like the last question which we have solved, that type of problem is very important that will improvise your concept on this topic. Clear? So thank you. This is Gopi signing off. You can prep smart, stay safe, be healthy, and please don't go outside from your home. Thank you. Bye-bye.